doing another pick a card. This time it is for love. And like, this is how do they feel about you? So take a moment, pause the video, pick the stack you want. And before I forget, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And hit that bell icon too, so you can be notified whenever I go live and upload new content. I am getting the channel back up and running. So, now I will get started. You're going to start with stack one with the crystal. Okay, so you have, love. Oh, wow, that should not be mirrored. Oh, that's why. Oh my goodness, I'm sorry, y'all. Love. So they love you. They feel very deeply connected. I'll give your relationship a chance. I'm so used to turning the card. So, apologize. I got a different setup for my camera. So, love. Give your relationship a chance. And past, present, and future. So they've been working hard, trying to figure out where they stand with you. And they feel like they have a new beginning with you, with the Fool. Like, they finally have stood up and said, hey, this is me. I feel this way. And they love you. And they're leaving their past behind them. And in the future, they're not going to look back. You are their future. Yeah. The past, they've put in all that work. They have definitely put the work in, put the effort in. And taking control, they're taking control over things now. They're creating that new start with you. And future looks promising with a Wheel of Fortune and this Seven of Swords. Definitely moving on, moving into a better time for the two of you. Like an actual relationship building here. Oh, yes, and risk. So take the risk. Take the leap of faith. Like, this is just like the Fool card here with, you know, taking that leap of faith and taking that new start. And study. So Spirit has its own special way of letting you know that it is time to study again. From time to time, it's important to go back and learn. Whether that's learning old things in a new way or learning something totally new, this is an opportunity to expand your mind. So learning about each other has a new love. And this person could be an Aquarius. They may have Aquarius in their chart. Could be very spiritual as well. Could be an air sign. And yeah. Not bad at all for those of you that picked stack one with the crystal. So let's move on to the second stack. Second stack, the turtle. So this person don't feel the same about you as you do them. And very well could be religious factors that are influencing this. I feel like with this one, that hate is a bit strong, but it's like extreme dislike that you don't meet their level. You're not in that same level as them. Past, this is why they have these feelings towards you. In the present, they're just taking a break. They're not trying to do anything. They are giving you your space. But the future could hold some communications, but I don't hold out hope for this person, for this relationship, this connection. So past, present, and future. In the past, definitely with the stress and the fears, the Hermit and the Nine of Swords, is that, just staying away. Like, there was a lot of negative energy there. And in the present, there's still that negative energy, but is a lot of confusion. So they're staying away. They're not wanting to rock the boat, per se. But the future, as I said, it does seem to hold some type of communications, but do not hold out hope for this relationship. And you got the High Priestess of Earth. And this card I have to look up the meaning for. It's a number 3 card. So this one is all about the body and the earth getting rest. So currently, or they are more focused on their self, on their body, their foundation, and so forth. Like, they're not focusing on a relationship at all. Let go. You do not need to continue on trying to pursue the relationship with this person. It says once you let go of the outcome, you'll be able to release all the emotional constraints that have held you back in the past. Trust in the higher good and guidance of spirit, as we have only your best intention at heart, and we'll do everything in our power to protect you. So you have the spirit guides around you, your spirit protectors, that are saying, you know what, no, this is not the relationship for you. And it very well may be a Cancer. You may have Cancer in your chart. They may have Cancer in their chart. Very emotional situations, and I feel a very crabby attitude, not a very pleasant attitude. So I hope that this made sense for y'all that picked number 2, and let's move on to number 3, the Dice. Truly are. Past, present, and future. In the past, they've completed a cycle with you. They've admired you, but there wasn't a relationship. Like, I don't feel like they've had a very good relationship a good track record on relationships. But presently, there is new communication here, new ideas coming through with them. And future is the King of Swords, which is definitely regaining that control over the communication. So their respect is going to flourish, and there could be potential relationship there. Past, present, and future. And I have to point out that this is all 3 major arcanas, so something big for you people that have picked this stack. respect, that admiration, and definitely like high admiration here. Could have been an, could be an Aries, could have Aries in the chart. You might have Aries in your chart. You have Libra and Pisces and Cancer as well. Present, the communication and new beginnings and regaining balance with you. Y'all are having this very equal give and take, I feel. And future wise, things will, more things will be revealed to you. The mask will come off and the light will be shown, if that makes sense. Oh, definitely. And then you got conclusion. So decisions will be made about the relationship. Decisions will be spoken about. Like, you will, yeah, we'll talk it over. Gratitude. So be grateful for those, for that you have. Be grateful for the relationship that you have with this person. Says life is one big continuous circle of giving and receiving energy. Be thankful for who and what's in your life instead of complaining about what you don't have. If you focus on gratitude, you'll start to attract prosperity and abundance. Nice. And the sign is Virgo. So this person is kind of stubborn, very grounded, very centered, but very stuck in their ways. But as I've said, they do respect you. They do want to have, I feel like this person does want to have a future with you, but there are things that need to be worked out for you to be able to have that relationship. So for those of you that have picked this deck, I hope this makes sense for y'all, and I hope everything works out for you. And that is all, y'all. So thank y'all for watching, liking, sharing, and subscribing. And until the next video, I'm out for now.